Hello and welcome to CSK Speaks. I am CSK, and before I even get started with this video, I want to first tell you, stay safe and stay at home. We have to take care of ourselves and our loved ones, and the only way to do that is staying safe and staying indoors. So my appeal to all of you, stay safe. Now let's get started with the topic for today. And I want to start with asking you a question. How many of you love Maggi noodles? I, for one, enjoy Maggi noodles. In fact, my mother, at one point of time, used to be fed up of the fact that I hog on Maggi noodles. But that's not the topic today. I'm not going to discuss why Maggi noodles or what is great about Maggi noodles. But I'm going to tell you something which I heard one of my parents call his son, and that is connected to Maggi noodles. He said, today's generation are the 2-minute generation, instant generation. That's what he meant to say. So I was curious. I asked the parent, what do you mean by 2-minute generation, and why do you call your son as instant generation? He says, sir, they just want everything right now, like right now. Then I began to think. I said, why them? Even us as adults who are living in this world, we are also instant in our approach. Everything we want it like right now. Now let me tell you a small little story and then come back to this instant feeling. It seems there was a rich guy. Now this man was very rich right from his ancestral days. So he had a lot of property which was passed over from generation to generation. Now this man, as it is rightly said, business was in the blood. So he started to grow the wealth, multiply it multiple times, and then he had so much of wealth that it really began to worry him. So he went around asking people as to, I want peace of mind. I want to be safe and mentally relaxed because this much wealth, I'm scared now. What if somebody steals it from me? What if somebody takes it away? Or I'm not able to handle this mental pressure. What can I do to get some peace? Because in that process of building wealth, he knew that he had compromised. He had compromised on his values. He had traded some deals and taken some shortcuts. So he wanted to get some peace. So people started suggesting. Some of them said, okay, why don't you get into charity? Why don't you donate something so that you feel good and that guilt is gone? He said, okay. And he went ahead and started donating some amount, significant amount of his net worth. But it did not make any difference in the longer run. Then some of them said, okay, if this does not work, why don't you build some kind of a temple or some kind of a place where people can get some benefit, like a shelter home for people and all that. He said, yeah, that's a good idea. At least that way I'm helping the fellow humans. I might have cheated some people in my business deal, but I'm helping someone, so I'll do it. So he went ahead and constructed a temple and a shelter home, and also started offering lunch and dinner in that place, free of cost. It was all good for some time, but then it really did not make a big difference. So he was kind of worked up with this thought. So he went about asking more and more, and he comes to this place where they say, you know what, we have the perfect solution for your problem. And that is, under that banyan tree in the village, there lives a saint. You go to that saint, and he is known to cure everybody of their mental illness. He has the solution for all problems, and I'm sure this saint is going to be the perfect person who can give you solution and guide you. So this fellow was jubilant. He started going to that banyan tree and looking around for that saint, but unfortunately he could not find the saint. The same people who guided him to the saint also told him that, look, that saint is like an enigma. He surfaces anywhere and everywhere. He is not found at one place. So let's do this. We will look around for him for some time. And then whenever he surfaces, we will send you a word and come down and meet him and have a conversation and get solution. So he said, fine, fair enough. And then rich man, he gave away some tips to those people and told them to be on alert. Few days passed. Finally, the saint was surfaced. So these guys who were looking out for him, spot him and then go running to the rich man and says, here is the saint and now you come. So finally, they both come together under that very banyan tree. And then here, the rich man tells his story or his problem to the saint. So saint says, okay, so do one thing. How much wealth do you have? No, I have got properties, I've got some cars, and I've got this, and I've got that. He says, do one thing. Sell all of it and put all the cash in one place, because you are disturbed as all of that is spread in different places and you have no control. Put everything together and don't come to me with the cash. Convert them into diamonds. Convert them into precious stones. Put them in a sack and then come and meet me. That way you will be assured that everything is in your control and it is in your hand. So the man was completely perplexed. He's like, wow, this is like a fantastic idea. So immediately he goes and sells everything and then puts everything together in a sack, all precious diamonds. And then on the appointed day, he comes back to meet the saint. The saint was there waiting this time. And then he says, okay, have you done it? He says, yes, all my net worth, my entire wealth is in this sack. And these are precious stones, diamonds, gems, all that. He says, okay, can I take a look? Yeah, of course. And he gives it to the saint. You know what the saint does? To the utter surprise and shock of everyone, the saint takes the sack and starts running around. He ran away. This rich guy is confused. He's like, he tells me to sell all my wealth and now I bring him and show him the sack exactly as he wanted me to do. And instead of appreciating me, this man is taking my sack and he's already ran off. Now he gathers his conscience and then he says, okay, I have to chase him down. It's my wealth running away. So he chases, but then he could not catch up with him. And finally, after 20, 30, 50 feet, he gives up. He's panting for breath and he's cursing his fate as to why did I even come to this saint. He is devastated, he's disturbed, and he's depressed. He walks back slowly to that very banyan tree, but there something miraculous happens. He comes down there, and before he sits, he finds the same saint sitting under the banyan tree with his sack. This guy goes there and says, what did you do? Why did you take this and run away? He says, it's okay. It doesn't matter. Now this is your sack. Take it. I was just fooling around with you. This guy is so happy that he got back his sack. He's like, thank you very much. For that few seconds, I started cursing you. I didn't know what to do. I cursed my fate. I should not have believed you. All these things I thought. But finally, you are a saint. You are what people say. I'm so happy that you are back and I got my sack back. And then he takes his sack, he checks it, being a businessman, and then puts it and tucks it safely in his pocket. Now, as the rich man begins to walk away, because he got back his wealth, the saint stops him and says, wait, all the while, all this riches was with you. And what was your problem? Your problem was, I don't have peace of mind. And you were unhappy. That's why you came to me in the first place. For that 30 to 50 seconds or maybe 1 minute, I ran with your sack. And that 1 minute, you were completely disturbed. And just after that, when you found me here and when I gave you back the sack, you were happy. And the happiness was caused by that very wealth, which was actually keeping you unhappy in the first place. He says, this is the secret of life. When anything you want is taken away from you for a while and given back, it gives you that happiness. And then he goes on and says, maintain a healthy distance between your wants and you, so that you can always be happy and you will always be sane to work towards it. Because everything, we get it so easily and quickly, we end up losing value for it and we start to question that very thing. Now let's get back to that instant generation title by that parent. Today, all of us keep asking, we want this, we want this. And if we don't get it instantly, we kind of get depressed or dejected, or we also get angry and frustrated. Now, the secret to live a balanced life is maintain a healthy distance between you and your wants. That way, you are not only in control, but you are also in pursuit. These two things are very integral for leading a balanced life. So now, what you do with your wants and needs is up to you. But let's understand, it's not about instant gratification, it's about delayed gratification. So let's work towards that. And that's the lesson I learned from this great story. And I connected it back to that parent calling all of us instant generation. Remember Maggie noodles. 2 minutes instant fix does not work. Thank you for watching CSK Speaks. And if you like this, do share, like and comment. But don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because you will get valuable information on real life issues. And my way of sharing it is through timeless stories. So if you love stories, you know where to come to. So subscribe to my CSK Speaks channel and stay tuned. Thank you.